We begin with the search for answers after that deadly synagogue shooting in San Diego. Overnight, hundreds gathered for a candlelight vigil to honor the victims of that deadly attack. And this morning, security is being stepped up at houses of worship all around the country. That's a live look at a Jewish religious headquarters in Brooklyn, where police, as you can see, are out in force. Chief National Correspondent Matt Gutman joins us now from San Diego with the latest. Good morning, Matt.
Hey, good morning, Rob. And that gunman walked into that synagogue lobby behind me, opened fire, getting off about 10 or 15 rounds before his gun jammed. Then two congregants chased him down this ramp and out into the street. Now, police caught him. He is in jail this morning, but this community, like so many others you mentioned, still on edge.
Getting another caller who stated there's a shooting at the synagogue, then disconnected.
The gunman didn't talk. He only shot, say eyewitnesses.
I realize now there's an active shooter at Temple. In front of me in the banquet hall, there's children, little kids. My granddaughters are here.
Rabbi Sraul Goldstein was one of suspect 19-year-old John Ernest's first victims.
I have no idea.
This is where you were shot.
I was centimeters away from death, literally.
Also shot 60-year-old Lori Gilbert Kay. She wouldn't survive her wounds. The fourth person shot while trying to shepherd children to safety.
People cry, screaming, run, but I focus all the kids. I focus the kids going this way.
Inside the sanctuary, terror.
My dear friend, her daughter was next to me. And I just remember getting her down and covering her with my body and telling her, please be quiet, please be quiet. I don't want the shooter to know that we're here.
But the alleged shooter was already gone. His gun jammed, and a military veteran helped chase him off. Minutes later, police would stop the 19-year-old nursing student.
We got an AR-15, a couple of loaded 30-round mags inside the vehicle.
Law enforcement says it's not his only alleged hate crime. In a post online, the alleged shooter bragged about trying to burn down a mosque last month. Both acts, he wrote, were a tribute to the massacre at the Christ Church Mosque last month and the Tree of Life synagogue shooting 6 months ago. Late Sunday, the president calling Rabbi Goldstein.
And you just take care of yourself.
8-year-old Noya Dahan was right there, saw the shooting, and is now on edge.
Do you feel safe here, Noya?
Well, I don't really feel safe because this is not the first and definitely not the last time this is going to happen. So now I just know, like, to watch out and stuff for dangerous things to happen.
So sad what that girl saw. Now, federal law enforcement sources tell me that the gunman purchased that weapon on Friday, just a day before the attack. And that short runway is what makes these lone wolf attackers so frightening and so difficult to stop. George.
That certainly does. Okay, Matt, thanks very much. Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.